Okay, move on.
Seymour, what made you a believer that the city of Buffalo could support a franchise?
Buffalo has always been a terrific sports-minded town, and hockey in particular was a very popular sport here. And the fans coming to watch the Buffalo Bisons in the very early days, they won championships in the American Hockey League, and I knew that a good part of that support also came from fans across the border in southern Ontario. And we were very much aware of the fact that hockey was a very good winter sport that the climate related to, and felt that with a major league franchise located here that it would be a big success.
Mr. Campbell, are you impressed with the manner in which the Knox brothers of Buffalo have taken on this challenge of forming a big league hockey organization?
Oh, I'm tremendously impressed, not only by the method and the manner in which they've conducted themselves, but their amazing tenacity.
Getting an NHL team, you know, it was hard. Seymour and Naughty were great people.
I can't say enough about my dad and my uncle. It's a great honor to see them on this wall for all their hard work and dedication over the years.
They love the team, they love the players. The Sabres were their life.
It's quite the wall. And I know my dad, his dream was always to bring the National Hockey League here to Buffalo. He believed in the city, he played here, coached here. He was just an unbelievable individual.
The Knoxes, what they did for Western New York is amazing, and it's still felt today.
We often said to ourselves, wouldn't it be great to have our own National Hockey League team right here in Buffalo?
They literally gave their lives to the franchise.
The city of Buffalo has been great for this franchise, and I like to feel that our franchise has helped the city's reputation and its image as well.
How are you, man? A long time no see. What, about a month?
Yeah. How long have you guys known each other?
50 years. Well, Fred Hunt Sr., my father, he was really probably Mr. Hockey here in Buffalo. He played for the Bisons, then became coach, then general manager.
He was good friends with my dad and Uncle Norty. They had the opportunity to go on the board for the Buffalo Bisons hockey team.
Freddie, of course, was a long-time resident of Buffalo. And he had all the contacts in Buffalo as a result. So he was a great guy for the team to pick up and to use his knowledge, his local knowledge particularly.
And then your dad told Uncle George, that George Collins, that the league was going to be expanding.
George Collins was the guy that really brought my father and your father together and kicked off the trail for the NHL. It was quite a story on a golf course it all happened.
They liked to play golf in those days, and they had the opportunity to go play. I think they played at Cherry Hill over in Canada.
I think they were just talking hockey, whatever. And he said, you know, you've got the wherewithal and the background and the name. Why don't you think about submitting an application? And then I went from there.
That's great.
Now, having the Sabres come here really changed the winters for everybody here.
Remember, the thing that happened here was there was nothing. There was two guys that had an idea, and then they got their friends and Bob Swados and, you know, other people. And it was just a conception, and a lot of people didn't think Buffalo was going to make it in the NHL.
Seymour and I had the opportunity to go to John Belay's house, who's an avid collector of sports memorabilia here in Buffalo.
They're coming over to take a look at some memories and take a look at some memorabilia to relive the past.
Hey, John.
Seymour, how you doing?
Good, nice to see you.
Welcome.
Thanks for having
here.
Us.
Come on in.
I'm a physical education teacher in Niagara Wheatfield. I grew up in the late 60s and early 70s. So when the Knoxes brought Buffalo hockey to the NHL, I was hooked right from day one. Come on in.
The Penalty Box Tavern.
Quite the collection, John.
This is quite the collection.
This is a lifelong collection of Buffalo sports memorabilia and history.
Oh my God. To see his collection, it was unbelievable.
I've probably been collecting somewhere around 50 years. I've got a few things that date back right to the beginning of the franchise. One of those things was the proposal in 1965 that the Knoxes put together. That's one of my really cool items that, you know, it means a lot to Sabres history. You've seen this.
Yes, this is what we gave in 1965, 66 to come into the league.
This was the PowerPoint presentation before PowerPoint, right?
It pointed out all the good points to Buffalo, the relationship we have with Canada, the Canadian fans, the strength of the fan support here in Buffalo.
Buffalo, being a very big American Hockey League city, was the favorite to get one of those six spots. And there it is, your strongest applicants, the Knox Group. And they should have been. They should have been picked in 67.
October 1967, the NHL expands from 6 to 12 teams. New clubs are the St. Louis Blues, the Philadelphia Flyers, Minnesota North Stars, Pittsburgh Penguins, Los Angeles Kings, and the Oakland Seals.
And for some strange reason, they finished dead last out of eight cities. And they couldn't figure out why they were passed over for NHL hockey.
And there was a couple of other owners that lobbied against them.
St. Louis got in because the owner of the St. Louis rink was Jim Norris, who owned the Chicago Blackhawks.
And the story came out that the Norris brothers were kind of anti-Buffalo, a bad business deal in Buffalo, so they didn't want Buffalo to get an NHL city.
They didn't give up. They were trying to find alternative ways.
But through the persistence of the Knoxes, you know, they kept pushing and trying to get an NHL team here. So they went after the Oakland Seals in 1969.
We got a lucky break that we were told that if we bought a quarter of interest of the Seals, that would help our cause.
The NHL saw this, their persistence, and then finally rewarded them in December 1969 with their own franchise.
The name of our team will be Buffalo Sabres.
It was aggressive, it was unique. I don't know if there was any college or amateur or any sports team that had the nickname Sabres at that time.
My sister has the original artwork where the logo was designed on canvas.
And that's one of one. There's no other. That's unbelievable. Like, yeah, that's crazy. Look at that.
That's fun because you got the gold this year too.
Yeah, it looks.
Yeah. Jerseys are done, yeah. Almost.
I wonder if.
I don't know if the Sabres got that from this rendering, because it's one of a kind.
Right.
Sabres Vice President Dave Foreman was busy supervising the refurbishing of the auditorium.
We really didn't get started on this job, or the city of Buffalo didn't, until around the 1st of July. And to try and do what's being done here in that period of time really creates a lot of problems. It's a battle all the way, and we're playing here on the 15th, and I can assure you that.
We had the opportunity to go to a room downstairs where they had a recreation of Memorial Auditorium.
Wow, this is great.
Look at this.
Oh my God.
Wow.
This is fantastic.
They did a great job with this.
Yeah. Wow.
Looking at that, we couldn't help but bring back memories of the good days of in the 70s and the 80s.
Robert going after it, he scores! Robert! And the Sabres win it again in overtime!
Great old building.
And they got all the louvers. This is really great. And the indentation.
It's where hockey really started here in Buffalo. It was a great building. This was really home for a lot of people in the old log.
Obviously, it was excitement all over the city because, you know, to finally reach that goal and have the NHL come to Buffalo was very exciting at that time.
It was electric. Everybody was excited. You couldn't get tickets. There was a buzz.
What do you think of the new Buffalo entry in the National Hockey League, the Buffalo Sabres?
I think it's a fantastic idea because Buffalo has needed this for a long time.
I think it's great for the town.
Well, it's just good for Buffalo.
Tell me, what do you think of Jimlack?
Well, I didn't like him when he was at Toronto, but I think he'll be all right here.
I think he'll do a good job. He's a good coach.
What a great hire. Yeah. I mean, for your family to hire somebody with such experience.
Punch Imlach was our very first coach and general manager, and he was instrumental in bringing just a fantastic team here to Buffalo. He drafted extremely well. The very first draft, back then they had a wheel that they spun to see who was going to get the first draft choice. Either it would be the Buffalo Sabres or Vancouver Canucks.
Gilbert Perreault was the best player in junior hockey. He's played for the Montreal Junior Canadiens, and boy, Punch really wanted him.
They had a carnival wheel.
And Buffalo had the numbers from 11 up to 19, and Vancouver had the numbers from 0 to 10.
Remember, it's Buffalo high, Vancouver low.
Oh, boy. Now you're really going to bring back out memories. The Sabres had a replica of what they had in Montreal when they spun the wheel.
Around and around and around it went. Clarence Campbell, the president at that time, announced that it was the number one.
Number is one.
It was like all the air went out of the room at the Sabres table.
My dad was at the table with the Knox brothers and, of course, with Punch, and my dad stood up and looked at it and said, Punch, that's not one, it's 11.
Freddie Hunt and Punch probably were yelling and screaming, Mr. Campbell, there's a mistake.
But wait, it's two ones, 11. The Sabres had landed first choice in the amateur draft.
Oh! Perfect. Congratulations, you got Mr. Parole.
I know what number I'm wearing. And I got number 11, which you can't make up.
We thought that was kind of a karma in the mix, and our fathers were looking down on us.
And that's when they knew they could pick Gilbert Perreault, and they did, and that's history, Hall of Fame history there.
Gilbert Perreault.
Looking back with how lucky we were to get Gilbert as our number one draft choice, he became Mr. Sabre.
It was huge. I mean, the other fellow that they would have got it had gone second was Dale Talon. Dale was a fine hockey player, but he wasn't Joe Perreault.
I was there to play hockey, and I really enjoyed my days there. And for the first year, the fans were just great. They were really happy to have the franchise there.
At the arena, the seats are freshly painted, the ice is installed, and the refurbished areas are completed. The auditorium is ready.
There's the guy right there. You just see the joy on your father's face. You really can.
Well, there's a funny story about opening night because everybody was wondering who had the puck. There was so much going on
right, that
nobody had a puck. You know, they had to get one from the trainer
really?
At the last second.
Did they really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. And here we go. There's the ticket for opening night.
Wow. A red.
October 15th. And the day we're filming this just so happens to be
October
15th.
Row 19. How about you?
October 4th or 5th, somewhere in there, we were playing Detroit, and I had this speech I had to give, and they never told me that Dad was gonna be talking or to be prepared for it. My dad had died in May, and I kind of lost it on the ice.
In 1970, we gambled that Buffalo would be a great place for a National Hockey League franchise, and we won that gamble.
Looking back at Mr. Knox, Seymour 3, he's very, very sorely missed, and I wish he was around to see this 50th anniversary because he would be very proud of what's happened, along with my dad. I wish the both of them were here.
When you admire the building, think of my dad, Seymour H. Knox III, whose presence is ever here with all of us. Godspeed.
Knox's, what they did for Western New York is amazing, and it's still felt today.
The Knox family were extremely kind and generous to my family, and I can't say how grateful I am for them to pursue that allowed my dad to achieve his dream, which was to bring an NHL team here to Buffalo.
Finally, and most of all, I want to thank all of you, the fans of the Buffalo Sabres, for your enthusiasm and devotion to our team.
Well, you know, when Dad's blowing in the wind, it means we're going to get a win.